buddy. Still fainting away here. Using a little bit of white and a little bit of purple in it. Just kind of starting to make these look a little more like waves splashing. Put it over the top of your purple, but stay on top of it. If you put it under it, it won't look like the moonlight hit it, right? It's common sense. Come on, get out here with it. And as you get further up from the moon, it won't be as white. A little splash going up in there, coming off the rock. You just kind of take your brush and just tap, 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 tap. Make some funny noises up in there. It make it go on a lot better. And while we used to weigh, we were checking out our granddaughter. I put a nice big clump of white up in here so we could fatten this moon up. And what we do is just put it on there and just kind of stretch it out all different directions. You don't want to overdo it. You want to leave it nice and bright. But you can drag it out a little so you've got some moonbeams going. Yep, moonbeams, right, you see. You know, you might have to layer that another time or two. But yeah, I probably should have left that. It's looking like a moon. Yeah, but that's fine. You want to highlight these clouds a little bit because they're getting hit by the moonbeams. See them? You could take a rag and you could smear the stuff a little bit. That's a little smear technique. Make it look a little cloudier. Mm-hmm. Like that. You know, whatever you need to use, you use. You know? I've even used a piece of carpet. I'll throw a dog tail up on you. You know, whatever's in the room. It's okay. You can use whatever you want to use. And then we're starting to get a little bit. Gotta get back a little and look at it. Rock here. Might have to have a little bit more. You know, just think like a rock. How rock you can get in this land, the sun, I mean, the moon. Keep going back and forth. Usually, you gotta put a little bit of, you know, when there's a rock, there's gonna be water around the rock. And it's sitting in the water, so you can. Yeah, but you don't wanna put white right there where it at because it's in the shadow. Give it a little purple on there. Just kind of move around like that. Splash it back, both in like that. Give it a little splash it up and down. Back and forth. Back and forth. Now I keep water flat. Back and forth. Water seeks its own levels. That's what you're trying to do. You want to capture that? That moonlight, it's starting to look like a moonshine. I could use some moonshine. I can guarantee that. I do like me some moonshine. Splash. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is where they come in and it's hitting the sandy beach. I'm going to change to a little bit. Make it right. Get some pink paint on it. It'll wipe out a little bit. You want to get this paint up in here. But I like to put the beach on first because you're going to have the water splashing up onto the beach. I'm getting a little bit this peachy color right up in here. Some red, a little purple. A little more pink than I. And just kind of lay it in up in here. You want to keep it darker over in these corners because we can make that look like something else here a little bit. You want to kind of just let it work the wood, you know. Work the wood. Let's go with the grain, baby. There you go. There you go. And make a little, your line farther apart as you get further away from the moon. So it looks like it's close. Close up here. Now, over here in the corner, go back here, go red, little peach, and put a little bit of dark blue in there. A little bit of dark blue. Come over here. There's water will be laying up in here. Make everything change color. came in, went back out. Came in, same hot dude. Hot time, looked at it. Looked at it, closed back, black and white. Now, that moonlight, it's gonna be hitting all the way back up in here, too. Get some white, put it on enough to thick. Like that. Get you a little pink. It'd be real big up here, though. And get it on there. And then you kind of stretch it out like it. You want to make it really wide in the middle there. Like this. Really wide. What up, America? This is Chuck Woods, Chuck Woods Art Show. We'd like to thank our sponsors this Super Bowl weekend, and we have a hard time finding any sponsors for my show. We got Viagra. Okay, we have to thank them. You know why. Anyway, we also would like to thank Penelope Ping Pong Balls. They're the greatest ping pong balls ever created. Thank you very much. You guys have a great weekend. Love y'all. Tune in my show. Buy some of my paintings on my webpage. And send all kinds of thank you letters for having me on the air.